Hello dear friends, today we're going to tell you about the worst bomb of the Soviet-Finnish War, which was also called Molotov bread basket. The name of this bomb is related to a statement attributed to Vyacheslav Molotov, Minister of Foreign Affairs. It is believed that traditionally dispersing aviation bombs were dropped on Finnish settlements, including the Finnish capital Helsinki. It happened on the first day of the Soviet-Finnish War, the 30th of November 1939. There were two words combining the name of the Soviet political figure and the weapons of the Soviet-Finnish War: Molotov bread basket and Molotov cocktail. Historians are inclined to believe that the name of the bottles with incendiary liquid, called Molotov cocktail, is a kind of reply of the Finns to the use of the bread basket by the Soviet troops. This name, incidentally, was first used by the Finns, but they used the phrase cocktail for Molotov. The historian Pavel Aptekar mentioned a speech made by Vyacheslav Molotov in response to accusations of bombing Finnish civilian population centers. Supposedly, the Soviet minister said that Soviet aircraft were not bombing at all, but dropping sacks of food. The air bomb was a cylinder with open inside walls, which swung open when the stabilizers, opening at an angle, twisted the bomb case itself. From the compartments separated by mesh grids, like shelves of bread baskets, the stuffing or explosive charge would fly out. Perhaps this was what gave rise to the popular name of the rotationally dispersing bomb. In addition, one of the modifications of the bomb spread containers with incendiary liquid for destroying objects over a large area. It had three modifications: 1 ton, 500 kilograms, and 250 kilograms. The bomb was over 2 meters long and consisted of welded sheets of 1 millimeter thick iron, and the bomb's inner cavity was divided into compartments, 3 to 4 depending on the modification. Into these compartments small explosive charges were placed, and their fuses were loaded before being placed in the case. The rotationally dispersing device of the bomb made it possible to spread the small explosive charge over a large area during bomb drop by taking advantage of the aerodynamic drag and centrifugal force, thereby increasing its lethal effect. For example, a four-section RRAB-1 from 3,000 meters hit the area up to thousands of square meters. If the altitude of the bombers increased by another 2,000 kilometers, respectively, the striking effect of the rotationally dispersing bomb also increased. The striking area of its explosive charge exceeded 1,000 square meters. There is statistical data on the destructive power of these bombs when they bombed Helsinki and other population centers in the country. Finland reported that as a result of the Soviet air raids on the 30th of November, more than 900 people were killed and more than 500 were severely wounded. All in all, the air attacks destroyed more than 2,000 stone and wooden buildings. It is also clear from sources that Soviet pilots bombed about 100 settlements. There is no information in these sources about the bridges, railroads, and other strategically important objects hit in the Finnish strongholds. It is said in the sources that explosive charges during these bombardments were used to set wooden buildings on fire in Finnish settlements. It is difficult to say what was the real contribution of the rotationally dispersing bombs, as they were used in combination with other air bombs in the bombing raids. There is little information about the use of rotationally dispersing bombs during World War II, but the fact that such bombs were not removed from the arsenal of the Soviet army was confirmed by a military pilot, twice hero of the Soviet Union, Vasily Rakov. In his interview, he said that it had always been difficult to load charges into rotationally dispersing bombs, the compartments of which contained more than 100 charges. Maintenance personnel at military airfields even nicknamed these bombs by their acronym – work, work, and all in vain. Although Rakov admitted the striking effect of such massive shells was impressive. That's all for today. If you enjoyed the video, please support it with your likes and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. See you all later!